Whatever. Deep sleep. Let's do it. I like the simplicity of all of the, wait, 2002? Oh, did these come before? It said a war, you know, it doesn't matter which one came first. So yeah, Script Welder 2012. I think that's nice. It's just like, I don't know if the titles of the game came before Steam, because as I said, I didn't play these when they originally came out, but addicting games. I was saying a while ago, I used to play a bunch of Flash games. It was addictinggames.com. I was working, it was my first job at the time, and I just needed something to do. So I played a lot of addicting games because it's like we worked from the house and there were like printers that I had to keep an eye on. So I could truly get into anything. So I'd have to stop, get up, make sure the printers were going kind of deal. I played a lot of addicting games. I don't know if this game was on it, but new game. Deep sleep. Let's go to bed. If you gaze long to an abyss, the abyss also gazes into you. Friedrich. Can't pronounce his last name. All right, got a key. Oh, that's not what I want to do. I've just woken up. Okay, can't open the drawers. All right, still the same thing. All right, you know what? It's pretty basic, but that's what you need. Just basic. It's locked. All right, what is... That's kind of sick. I like that little screen effect. A cube with a keyhole. Do I need another key? Phone's ringing. There are big cracks in this wall. All right, I probably need a hammer. I'm sure this note gets to you somehow. At this point, you should know all this is not real. I hope the inner awakening went well and you have full lucid control over the dream. Sincerely, yourself. Thanks. It's locked. Nothing here. No, I was just there. Oh, let's pick up the phone. Wake up. Oh no. Flashlight. Wake up. Stop. All right, we're getting out of there. I don't like that. It smells really bad from here. Just a whispering of wake. I don't like it. It won't budge. A puddle of water. Oh, this opened. Let's go in. Yeah, use your flashlight. Oh, it has no batteries. Okay. What's this? Piece of old cloth. That was mean. So is someone burned in there? I think he's okay. My lucky piece of coal. Can I put it in here? Alright, we're okay. Alright, so I think that's just their freak out. Alright, we need to find some batteries. I'm soaking wet piece of old cloth. I did it. Oh, we gotta go up. Oh, hey, you're in my bed. Good. All right, you know what? We have something, so if we need to get something high up, we can get to it. I don't know if you can mix or anything. Locked. Did I just say I love you? I don't know why I'm going near my microphone to see if I can listen better. Okay, you know what? No, I don't. I throw the lucky coal at it. All right, can't do anything with what I have. And I still have a cube with a keyhole. What did this say? Right, okay. It's very dark, you're scared of the dark, and your flashlight needs batteries. All right, you know what? I said before, like, how scary can these games be? Because I love point and clicks, but there's something about, let's say, Silver Chains, which was first person, that made it a little more immersive because of just how it's made. Sometimes it just happens. But those hands on the fire thing was a little frightening. It was scary, I'll say it. It needs a lever. Wait, okay, hold on. I did it. All right. Hey, key. What if it's a screamer? Okay, you know what? Oh, I see something. Oh, two. Hold on. 8, 3, 5, 9. 8, 3, 5, 9. Okay. Oh, right, right. This was, I can't get to that yet. Oh, batteries. You wanna know what I like? He retained some of his assets, because those are the batteries from- Shut up, I know I have to make it. Me screaming at my fears. Sometimes you just gotta grab your fears and just shake them. Wake up. Oh, I'm trying to. How dare you. Oh God, life is cold. Life, wait. Something, something without his plushy tiger. What could it mean? A little Cody is lost without his plushy tiger. It's old and squeaky. So I probably need the plushy. Wait. It's so dark. Let's see. Oh. Yep. Oh God, please. The door's already open. Oh my God, okay. I was like, oh God, please don't let the batteries die. All right. All right, we're Minecraft. Nope. I hope I didn't need anything else. I wonder what happens if it, like, is able to get you, though. Alright, so this I can use for that wall. Oh, you okay. I really like that little screen effect. I'm not quite sure how I feel about having to use the item multiple times. Having to manually open the door, I guess, helped immerse you. But it's hard because I think it makes it more immersive, but at the same time, it's very small and it's very nitpicky, but I'd rather save myself a few seconds and not have to do it. But I appreciate it. Annette. At least I still have the soaking wet piece of cloth and my lucky piece of coal. Hey, creepy painting, is it? I mean, it looks like someone just took a picture in front of the lighthouse. Yeah, she looks mean, but I don't think it's that creepy. Please put it down. Yeah, I'm very curious what happens if you... Wait, now that I think of it, when I was reading reviews, someone's saying there's a few points where there's time stuff, but even if you die, you just get reloaded pretty quickly. So I guess that was one of those things where you have to leave pretty quickly. I like it. It gives a bit of a sense of dread. Was there anything else? I really don't think so. I think... Yeah. I think that's all I can really do right now is go to the lighthouse. Wake up. It's old and squeaky. Can I like clean it? Okay. Wait. My daughter went to sleep and she never woke up. Uh-oh. My son's personality has completely changed overnight. Mayor's wife possessed? Text by Otasin. Nobody even knows when it has started. One thing for sure, she's not the same person our mayor married 7 years ago. A man killed his family after waking up from a coma. You are next. It's time to pay a price for playing with things you don't comprehend. Yeah? Is it time to pay a price? Alright, so you can only go the one way, I guess. I wish you could click that just to see, like, I guess it's probably just the light. Probably need a light. I wish he would at least say something about it. Maybe I could clean the painting. Sure, there's nothing I'm missing. I mean, there probably is, but nobody shows up. It never hurts to try. So I need to find a way to get up there. Oh. Oh, a hook, huh? A net with a hook. Oh, actually. There we go. It looks somehow familiar. Let's get the key. Shut up. I don't know, it looks like kind of like a horse. I can't turn it back on. I wonder if I made a mistake. Is there anything else in here? No. Okay. No, this is where I want to be. All right, so I have a key. A golden key. I don't like... Nope, 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 nope. I don't think there's anything I needed a key for in here. Could be way wrong, though. Alright, I don't think there's any point to coming here yet. Oh, I wonder if I return the key to... Does this still say wake up? No, it shut it all off. So what's the key to then, I wonder? All right, spooky things about how everyone changed. You know, the wife possessed thing though. Like, people change in 70 years sometimes. It's just how it is. Oh, wait. A shiny gem. Oh, nope, nope, nope. Can't believe I forgot about that. All right, do I put the shiny gem in the lighthouse, though? Ha! Wait. I wonder if I have to go out and see how it changes. Oh. All right. Okay. And then, just like that, I woke up. The nightmare was over, but my life had changed forever. Was it all just a dream, or were these creatures real? I have to know. I just have to know the truth. I can't stop thinking about it. I have to go back. Back to the deep sleep. Ah, I was like, why is there a thing? It's because there's light shining through from the green screen. All right. So let me fix it. I'll be right there. All right. The one annoying thing, and I wish the Twitch had a trilogy, is like, oh, you gotta update the game, which P4A was saying, but I just didn't because honestly, I doesn't make that much of a difference, but it's just annoying. I wish it was like the Deep Sleep trilogy. But I'm not go- because this sounds lame, but I don't think it makes a lot of a difference if I switch the three titles for this game. All right, so if I hit continue, where does it take me? Okay, it takes right before you do the sequence. That's neat. All right, quit. That was short, but I really enjoyed it. All right, Deep Sleep. I like that. If you beat the game, it like gives you an idea to let you know. All right, we gotta go into a deeper sleep, y'all. I've always wanted to experience a lucid dream. A dream in which you are awake. A dream in which you can be anyone and anything. But something went wrong and I ended up having a terrible nightmare. Before I woke up, I encountered monsters that wanted to hurt me. I don't think they were part of my dream. It felt like they came from the outside, from the depths. The nightmare didn't fade away like I thought it would. I couldn't stop thinking about it. What if it was real? I became obsessed with it. I don't know why. Maybe I just wanted to prove myself wrong? So I went to a local library to see if there were any past records of dreams similar to mine. Old night outside. Psychology books. More books about human psyche. Poorly translated. Nothing interesting. Nothing about lucid dreaming. Psychology of dogs, huh? I've just arrived. I guess. Those are lights outside. Alright, let's go. Piece of paper. As long as you don't know you are dreaming, you are safe. Am I dreaming right now? I bet I am. Good. I'm in the dream again. A dusty old book. All the pages are blank. No, 1 of 15. Not what I'm looking for. A novel by someone called Eldak. That's the second thing. I think there was a mention of Eldak in the Don't Sleep or Don't Escape 2. Physics, thermodynamics. Nothing interesting, nothing about dreaming. Okay. Hey, it's different. A book is missing here, I see. The book fits here perfectly. All right, batteries. This painting looks familiar. Oh yeah? A piece of paper. Oh, I need to find out 15 notes. That's fun. It's locked. Looks like an elevator. No power. All right, let's keep going. Oh, okay. Nope. Bert! It's locked. It's dark down there. What's this way? You again. Why be your turn? The place is dangerous. Have we met? Not in person. However, last time I left you a record message which led you to the lighthouse. You shouldn't have come back here. Is he the one that was saying, wake up, wake up, blah, blah, blah? Because there was, like, at the end, there was something, but I couldn't figure out how to get it. Okay, hold on. All right, who are you? My name is not important. I'm a traveler like you. You're a real sleeping human. As crazy as it sounds, I'm as real as you are. All right, let's fix this a little bit. All right, that looks good to me, I think. All right. I did. What are you doing here? Currently I'm hiding. Your actions have drawn their attention. Can't you wake up? Maybe I can, but I just don't want to. Maybe whatever life I had out there is even worse than this. It's none of your beeswax. Who are they? The shadow people, but we shouldn't talk about them. Here, take this scrap of paper. It might shed some light on the matter. Why would anyone want to be here? Well, you're here, aren't you? You had your chance to escape, yet you've returned. This place lures you, and then it consumes you like a swamp. This is not only my dream. Dreams are like personal pockets, but only to a certain level. At this depth, it's one big world for everyone, much like reality. I had to know if this was real. Now you know, but they won't let you reach the lighthouse this time. Can you tell me more about them? Stop talking about them. They can sense it. You just don't talk about them. That is basically the first rule of all travelers. Can you help me? I risked my life for you once. This time you're on your own. Stay hidden if they sense you, if they find you. I've killed one of them with light, and that's exactly where you should go away. I don't want to be anywhere near when they get you. I don't know how to wake up. Of course you don't know. People spend years preparing for this, learning, practicing. I had no idea. So you've jumped into a pool that's too deep without even checking it, and you haven't learned to swim. Now leave me before they find it. Bro, I just wanted to test out... Apparently I just want to test out lucid dreaming. What are you doing here? Okay, the depth of one big world. Think of it as a river that joins with another river and so on. At some point, they all fall into the ocean. Are there any other travelers? This realm is huge. You can find travelers from time to time. For example, have you met Felicity? She lives in the attic. Don't go there. She's dangerous. I'm going in the attic. Why is Felicity dangerous? Because she's crazy. That's why. She's been here for too long. She couldn't wake up and she just lost it. Watch out for her. How long has she been there? She's lost both her mind and her humanity. How long have you been here? None of your beeswax. I'm not crazy if that's what you suggest. Wait, I'll go away if you help me. If you killed one of them, they will hunt you. They've probably already blocked all the ways out. This means you can only go deeper. Why and how should I? Deeper sleep, get it? Because they might not look for you there, and sometimes you have to bounce off the bottom to reach the surface. What about when I get deeper? I don't know. I've never been deeper than I am now. Hopefully you find something to bounce off. Thank you! You're welcome. Now, if you don't have any more questions, please leave as promised. Okay, bye. Is this like the same? Nope. I should use the handle, and there is no handle. Oh, won't budge. Okay, so I gotta find the password for that. It's locked from another side. Can I use the key? Oh no, it said from the other, from another side. Okay. That's where I just was. All right, so that's not the key to that. I need to get there. Oh, didn't he give me a note? Okay, so it was just deer. Three. That was mean. a bed, Willie, Cody, Timmy, Danny, Toby, Tommy. Okay, bye. Probably other lucid dreamers. All right, so I need power. So 3, 3, 2, 3. Nope. Which way was it? Why do I do this? Deja vu? I'm not good at being stealth. Ha! Because the dialogue was changing, I was like, it must be achievement related. A piece of paper. All right. Oh, that's right. Let's get into the options. Piece of paper. The handle's stuck. Old toys. Barely see my reflection. I'll just pretend I didn't hear that. Piece of paper. Vaguely sound like it said, please help me. A needle. Or stabbing. Oh, a plushie. Oh, I needed this for... There was like a room and it was like, oh, Cody's lost without his tiger. Handle's stuck. I'm gonna have to come back for that. Let's give Cody back his tiger. There you go. I have a feeling I have to give them things. I first encountered this phenomenon in the early 80s, but it would seem they exist since the dawn of the human race, commonly known as the Shadow People. Something that possesses our bodies. All right, as long as you don't know you're dreaming, you're safe. So that's the issue. Because I've been lucid dreaming, I know. Good. Oh, a pointer, okay. Missed it. Oh, another no. All right. I wonder if I can actually use that pointer to... There's one room. Good. All right, I probably need string to go with the needle or thread, needle and thread. You know, I was saying how like point and clicks, they can be scary, but I don't think I've been truly scared. I'm a little scared. It's done a good job. I don't know if this came before or after or like in between Don't Escape, but I think he's done a good job of creating some good immersion. Okay, it's locked. That's it. Like this corner's coming up. Specifically that corner, so I wish I could grab it. I might have to go back to that, Okay. Okay. It's dark. Hey, a mushroom. Pile of stones. Can I go back? I want to see if there's anything I missed. More mushrooms. With a hole, pile of rotten bags. All right, so I need to put something that's like 11 pounds on here. Piece of paper. Got half the notes. Nothing happens. An old looking fountain? Yep, it sure is. Alright, how do I go back? Okay. All right, so I probably have to put something in the bag, but I have to fix the bag first. Can I grab like the... Oh, a pile of flour. Yeah, it has a big hole, so I gotta fix that and then get the flour. Okay, that makes sense. I was like, I thought it was a bag of flour. I misread Pyle's bag. I'm like, just use that forehead. But you need to fix the bag and then you can put the flour on there. Oh, I missed that the first time. I definitely don't want to miss any of the notes. I want to see what the whole thing says. I guess you could also use the bag for the stones. What was that? I guess if you spend too long, it's just gonna make noise to freak you out. All right, let's go back in. I can't stand, All right, so I need some thread. I still have the pointer, so it's very important. I just want to double check everything to make sure I don't miss anything. There's like a hook over there, but there's nothing on it. Handle stuck. Yeah, an old sewing machine. Please use it. Phone line's dead. All right, so an old sewing machine, but I guess it won't work. Handle's stuck, so I need something to unstick it. All right. Oh, wasn't that locked? No, it was locked from another side. Can't even examine the little, moose head. Oh, hey, a piece of paper. Wait, oh, Timmy and Tommy, okay. I guess there's nothing here other than, haha, you were dreaming. All right, so there's no point in coming all the way back here. Hey, Big Potato, how you doing? All right, so I also need to turn on the power. It sure does look like an elevator. I think I'm done here as well, because I can't find anything else. Yeah, all there is was the pointer. A code. That's locked. Oh, I want it. Oh, this is a different way, I guess. Okay. Stop. Is that like a thread from a scarecrow? Okay. We got what we needed to put things in a bag. Oh, and oh, I did hear about how they're supposed to be like, hold on a second. I'll get right back to you. The dog is just going off and I need to see what he's on about. I heard that there was like snow and ice expected kind of around a bunch of areas. On Friday, we're supposed to get some snow. I was shocked because I guess in New York, there was like a lot of snow sometime last week. And usually what happens when there's snow in like New York City, eventually we get it up here, but we got some, you know, it would snow on and off. It's snow heavy, but we didn't really get that much, maybe an inch, if that. It melted pretty quickly, thank goodness. I was very, very shocked. Oh, okay, that was another path, and I just never noticed. Alright, we put... Shut up. Whatever's... screaming, it better not bite me. Oh, hey. Oh, we almost have all the notes. A small mound of ground. Oh, well. Oh, there was a key in the pot. Okay. Seems to go deep. Go in. Are you telling me that... Okay, so there's a point you gotta put something that's like basically 11 pounds on a shelf. Are they trying to tell me that a bunch of stones isn't enough for that? I mean, I guess not, but... the stones didn't look that small, so I think they could be pretty heavy. The flower's definitely gonna be enough. As someone who works for a bakery, flour's heavy. Okay. We did it. The handle's stuck. What a surprise. There's another stuck handle. That's all it led to. Alright, we almost have the whole... No. Hey, we got another piece. Alright, I first encountered this phenomenon in the- I used to sling 50 pounds of condiment starch at the- Yeah, they're heavy. I can kind of lift one, but like, just a little bit because I'm not strong enough. They're very, very heavy. And we need all the- we need flour and we need a bunch of- You know, for baking, obviously, when we make our mixes or when we wanna, like- Yeah, make our mixes, just so that when we make the baked goods for the folks, it's just easier for us to make. It's really heavy. We were very lucky to have, like, a family friend and his son move. Wait, I just realized I'm kind of floating in air when I was, fixing the webcam. Oops. I think I didn't notice because the background was, kind of dark. Please grab. There. Perfect. But with the background, yeah, I, oops. Oh, well. It's a spooky game, spooky floating body. But yeah, bags of cornstarch or flour or anything are, very heavy. All right, I gotta get all my windows back. Oop, and then oop. Boop. Okay. So I first encountered this phenomenon in the early 80s, but it would seem they have existed since the dawn of the human race. Commonly known as the Night Folk or Shadow People, they live in the realm of dreams, but desperately want to something to our realm by possessing something on occupied bodies. As long as you don't know you're dreaming, you are safe. They attack when they sense a mind detached from its body, which sometimes happens during comas, but much more often during oobs and lucid dreaming. In case I don't get all the notes, I want to see what it says. So it's notes on... All right, so we got two stuck handles. We still have a pointer. All right, but we have another key and I think I know where it goes. Hey, a pipe wrench. Oh, is that really it? Oh, probably. Okay. I know what those are too. All right, it's already open. There's another one. I don't remember where. Thank you. Because there were three. Alright, it wasn't in there. I think it was, yeah, it wasn't here. Valve's already open. I think the most I ever carried back in my first job is we would have like 30 pound rolls of, I say film because it was more like the material that you can stick. It was like films. I don't know. You could call it film. Or we also had like a big laminator. So when you had to change the laminate, that was pretty heavy. But because it was longer, it was easier to lift because I could use my arms. But I had to work really hard to be able to lift and carry it. And mainly because the first time I tried to do it, I dropped it right on my foot, the 30 pound thing of film. It was, it hurt a little. I'll say it. It wasn't very poggers. Of course it did. But the fountain's probably going. Okay, that's, I kind of like that. That controls the one down there. Interesting. All right, can I go and reset it? Almost got it. Nope, please. Thank you. just press buttons until it works. I'm sure someone actually been able to get it accomplished that way. I could turn that one off. Nailed it. I guess there's... that doesn't do a lot. All right, now we can go to that well. Oh, I think we need to fix this. He doesn't do anything with the bucket, though. Water powers the mill. Oh, and now we can use the elevator. Oh, I don't like that. I'll use the elevator. We didn't get all the notes, but we got the gist. It's held by some screws. All right, so we need a screwdriver. Oh, this is the other side. All right. Oh, actually. It doesn't stop at ground floor. So what's on the second floor? Or is this the second floor? Nope. Door's closing, I'm trapped. Help. Up. Let me through. Oh, grab it. Let me out. Hey, we're safe. I was like, oh God, oh God. All right, good. We need this for the, Oh, I guess first floor is probably where we came from. All right, hopefully I didn't miss anything. Because we still have, like, one more note. All right, that's where I got the wrench. Which way was it? This way. Oh, the poster's gone. Oh, I went too far. I thought this is the way to the thing that had, Oh, nope. Please? I think there will be no going back. To be continued. I did not get the last note. A young boy wakes up from a 3-month coma. A 9-year-old boy from a local orphanage who has been in a coma since February woke up yesterday in good health. Doctors previously didn't give him much chance of ever regaining consciousness. Boy's first words after opening eyes were, "My tiger has found me! Oh, I did it!" See you at the final depth. I did not get the last note. That's okay. Alright. The Deepest Sleep. This is a good series. New game, 2014. I woke up in the middle of a night. I couldn't move or say anything. And there was someone in my room. A cold night outside. Is someone there? My bad, I can't move. Oh my god, I can't move. He seems to be looking at me. Ah! That's mean. All right, we got a sealed vase. Shelf's empty. Let's go. Let's walk into the abyss. Let's go left. Hello, Bert. I'm sure this note gets to you somehow, so you followed the stupid traveler even though you knew what's gonna happen. You're at the bottom depth now. There's nothing beneath you. It is important that you avoid the bottom feeders. They sense motion, so don't make any sudden moves near them. Also, don't go to the dark church. The darkness there will suffocate you. Find a ladder. It should take you back to the surface. Sincerely, yourself. Oh, so I'm Bert. A reel with no handle. All right. The bottom feeders, they live at the bottom layer of the realm of dreams, feeding upon everything that ends up there. Even the shadow people fear them. They are blind, but can sense vibrations and movement. By staying perfectly still, you should be safe. It's moldy and stinky, smells like paint, a hammer. Can I break the vase? Hey, cause shiny gem. Screwdriver. Moldy and stinky. Okay. Gem is stuck in the statue's mouth. Alright, I got two gems. No handle or keyhole. Okay, there's one last door that I didn't go through. That's where I came from. Nope. It's perfect. Okay. I am a puzzle god. stone skull. Oh. Small hole. Does the gem go in there? Look at that. Is that it? Just a handle? Alrighty. Oh, do I have to put these back to get out? Alright. Alright, you know what? I'll allow it. Alright, so I have a screwdriver, a hammer, and a handle. Oh, okay. Let's go. Good. Bars won't move. Okay. Let's keep going. Oh, Bert! Hanged with a red rope. All right. Sewer gate lock system. Real. Door goes up. Bar goes up. Something about the noose. Aimed with a red rope. Oh, okay. Do we bonk him? Oh, Bert. Probably if I can get Bert down, I'm A-okay. I thought that was, the doorway. It was not. Wait, what did it say? All right, find a ladder. Okay. I was like, wait a second, red rope. Okay. That's a pretty good one, I'll say. I've really enjoyed the puzzles in this game. They're not overly difficult. But a couple you gotta think about a little bit. Oh, okay. I've been devoured. Don't go that way.
Thank you.
Waiting for the bar to go down. Oh, I see. All right, I know what I must do. Not too bad. Okay. The cabinet's empty. Doors are empty. I'm not going back there. All right, so let's go. Wait. Oh, a key. Okay. I kind of like that. A music box. Let's open it. Can't do that. Never mind. Something's blocking it. All right, empty grease can. All right, that's where I was. A fat, oily mushroom. Stone tablet. I have to get the oil out of it. Okay. Use the screwdriver. No. A wind-up key. All right. So I need to get the oil so I can get that. Oh, wait. All right, hold on. The answer was, can I not go back anymore? Oh, okay. Hold on. Okay. Don't think that's right, and I, you know, we'll see when I get the other pieces. Okay. I figured it out. I think I have to grab it quick. Pile of plates. Thank you. Okay. All right, we got what we needed. Is there anything else in here? No. So I have a wind-up key. There's nothing in here. Ah, here we go. That would be very painful. All right, let's go back. Alrighty. The pieces I have right now go to the top. Was this always here? I don't think so. Hey, man. Did anything else change? All right. I'm going to take a quick break to go to the bathroom, and then I'll be right back to this.
Well, everyone's dead now, and I just found scrap, so... Whoopsie. Okay, I'm better by myself anyway. I don't need those losers.
Oh god. All right. Come on. Come on. I might have messed up. Okay, well, you know, it's fine, we're okay.
What?
You got this, buddy.
You can do it.
You got it!
Go on, just a little bit more. Oh.
Do you see it? Do you see your prize? You got it!
Almost.
Yay! Yay!
turn the music off? I don't know what I...
Alrighty. Just looking to see if there's anything I'm missing. It's like a lid. I think this is... Oh! Alrighty. Hey, I figured it out. Rotten meat, yuck. Cinnamon toast. Those are some pretty good throwbacks to his other games. Oh, we're on the other side. Okay. Smells bad from there. I want to see if anything's changed. I mean, we had that guy. He was in my bed, or in a bed before. All right, and then we need one more. Stuck for good, all right. Yeah. All right, so I need the last piece or the last stone slab. Is there anywhere else to go? Don't like the sound of that. A bit old, but still crunchy. Broken stove. Oh my god, I did not- oh. Did it sing? It sounded somewhat sing-songy. But yeah, I completely missed it, that. Okay. Hey, I found the ladder. Go. Hey, is that me? Now I remember. They've got me. All this time I've been... one of them. Oh, okay. I was like, that's not the end, right? I'm a monster. One of them. That's why he couldn't look into mirrors. That's true, because like... no, never mind. I remember in Don't Escape, I think you randomly break a mirror. Okay, we did it. There he was, a traveler just like me before. The moment he saw me, he started running. My ticket out of here, my chance to finally wake up. I just had to catch him to possess a sleeping body, a body that I could wake up in. But did I really want to? Have I really become a monster so easily? A monster I feared so much? What if I just let him escape? I hesitated and I let that man go. The vicious cycle cannot continue. I've remained here forever. Okay. Here in the deepest sleep. They said the thing. I wonder if they let you go back and do the other thing, like chase him. That was pretty good. You're the monster. I guess you go to do lucid dreaming. They possess you. You don't know it. And when you realize it, you can either possess the body and just keep looping or just stay there as the monster. That was pretty good. I have to say, nothing too, no pun intended, deep, but I liked that. I liked the puzzles. I liked the timing because even though, let me turn this down a bit. Let me turn it down a bit more. Anyway, sorry. Yeah, it was nothing special, but I liked the puzzles, the monsters. When it was timed and they were coming for you, I feel like unless you really freak out and you're really not good. Oh my god. My foot and con something. I feel you definitely have enough time where you won't get caught up. The monster where you have to slowly move around, I thought was pretty interesting. And it didn't feel that punishing, honestly. I liked it a lot. It was simple, they were short, but I liked the little story. It's a cycle of getting possessed and then continually possessing more and more travelers, because he was an ex-traveler. And I saved Cody. I saved that kid Cody. I gave him the tiger. But yeah, I'm a little curious. Can you continue and grab him? Let's just see. What's the other ending? Because it usually gets you... okay, let's go. Let's get the kid. A traveler like me, the moment he saw me, started running. To get out of here, a chance to finally wake up. I just had to catch him a bite that I could wake up in. But did I really want to? Have I really become a monster so easily? A monster I feared so much? Yes, you have. It was so easy, almost too easy. I took his body away, leaving him in this chaotic world. I will wake up now, and the chaos of this place will follow me up to the surface. And the cycle will continue. Okay. So it's either, you know... What about the other ones, though? I guess the only one is the one that's been chasing you the whole time. So either you stop it all and you let the one traveler go, or you take him over and wake up, but someone else is lost. I liked it. I thought it was pretty good. I can see how it was popular. I think this game is definitely a lot better than Don't Escape, but I did like Don't Escape. Just this had a bit of a story and it had puzzles, and I think it did a good job of being a little scary. A couple of little jump scares here and there, but nothing too horrible. And I feel like it was done purposefully. Like, you see someone coming at you and then it comes at you quick, screaming. Usually I don't like those, but given the context, I thought they did it well. Good atmosphere. I liked the puzzles. Nothing was too difficult. What would I give it? I don't know. It was short, but I think it told its story, so I don't mind. I kind of do like you can make the choice at the end, and then they let you repeat, and they let you go the other way. I think it's nice. I think more games need to do that. And I think more games are these days, where it's like, if it's multiple choice, you can just go back and choose something differently, you know? I said before, I wasn't generally a fan of games with multiple endings. If there's a bunch of different choices and the endings are more different and affected by it, that's fine. I talked about with Stigmatized Property how there's two different endings, the good ending and the bad ending. But you really had to do a lot of searching for the shrines in Stigmatized Property. And it just kind of seems random and haphazard if you find them. But I liked this game. I got it on sale for $2.50. To support the dev, I thought the games were good, both of them. Don't Escape, I'd probably give... a 7 out of 10. I thought the first one was very rough. The second one I liked because I felt like I was learning as I kept going. The first one, I kind of learned, but it didn't seem so obvious what I could learn from. And the third one started to build a story, but it again felt a little haphazard of what you could do differently as opposed to feeling like I was learning. And I didn't want to play too much of it. I was just, okay, that's it. So the first game, maybe a 7 out of 10, maybe 6.5, I don't know. And the Deep Sleep Trilogy? I'm trying to think, because like he talked about going to the attic. That's where Felicity or Felicia was, and don't go in there. I don't get that part. I don't know if there's an... Oh, Felicity is the thing that was chasing me. Okay, never mind. I understand now. I remember. I think a 9 out of 10. I think a couple things. It wasn't hard to find things, but once in a while, I would try to touch things and I'd either leave a room or anything like that. At least the, little crosshair was responsive as to whether or not you could do something. So I really like the Deep Sleep Trilogy way more than the Don't Escape Trilogy, but I'm glad I played them both. So let's get out of there. Yeah, and I finished all of them. Um, All right, so is ending A where you just wake up, or ending B where you end the cycle? Oh, and silence the grave. Sneak past the bottom feeder without drawing its attention. All right, so deeper sleep, collect all the notes. The deepest sleep, find the sleeping beauty. Didn't do that. And then there's one more that's locked. I'm a little curious what that is. Let's play the music. Steam achievements. Because all these I can just really quick. Deep Sleep Trilogy. Let's see. Oh, so. So find the Sleeping Beauty, which might be Felicity. Collect all the notes. And the last one is to ring the bell over and over in either deep sleep or deeper sleep. I don't remember which one I kept ringing the bell for. That doesn't seem too bad. All right, so that's going to be it for me. I played Don't Escape, the Don't Escape trilogy. I played the Deep Sleep trilogy. I liked them both. It seems like he learned from the Don't Escape trilogy, and he... Let's see, because I feel like Deep Sleep trilogy. No, I want to know which came first. All right, Deep Sleep 2012, Deepest Sleep 2014. So it seems like it took a year for each one. Oh, wait. Deep Sleep 4 upcoming. In January 2021, Scriptwriter announced Deep Sleep 4. The official website provides a synopsis. You embark into the depths of the eerie dome of dreams. You will have to face the horrors of the worst nightmares to find what you seek. Ah. All right. Well. Yeah, I enjoyed them both. I just enjoyed Deep Sleep more. I thought the story was simple. And I feel like it was good pacing. As short as they were, the pacing was really good. And it's not that long. It looks like I spent a little less than 2 hours. If I was an asshole, I could just get the rest of the achievements and return them. But I'm not. As I said, I want to support the developer. I paid $250 for it. Because it's $5. So I would say it's definitely... Not for everyone, because I know some people don't like point and click. Some people might not like puzzle games, and not everyone's into horror. But I definitely enjoyed it. I don't think it was too bad. As I said, I thought it was scary. The atmosphere was good. Glad I played. Tomorrow, I don't know what I'm playing. Oh, you know what? Tomorrow we're gonna play Happy Game. I've had it installed for a while. I haven't played Chill Corner for a few days. I've had Happy Game installed for a while. So, you know what? Let's play Happy Game tomorrow. It is a... Please. Horror game. A little boy falls asleep in a horrible nightmare. Can you make him happy again? Probably not, but, you know, we'll see. So, thank you.